roughly 80% of children with cancer are cured. Number one, the cancers that they have are more amenable to multi-agent chemotherapy and intensive chemotherapy approaches. And number two, because children don't have all of the other comorbidities, heart disease, diabetes, and pulmonary problems that adults sometimes have. So generally, children are much, much more resilient and tolerate therapy much better, and tolerate intensive therapy much better. Since most children with cancer are cured, we have an increasingly expanding population of survivors of childhood cancer. And by the year 2012, one in 500 young adults under the age of 30 is anticipated to actually be a survivor of childhood cancer. We recognize that the treatments that we use have short-term complications and toxicities, as well as long-term complications. We've learned from some of that information by doing comprehensive longitudinal studies, and we've modified our therapy. And we now have developed programs whereby we try to track children once they complete clinical trials, and once they leave home to go away to college and finish college and go out and get married and start developing careers on their own. We've developed a tracking program so that we can actually continue to remind survivors that they need periodic surveillance, not surveillance for their cancer coming back, but surveillance for some of the long-term cardiac or pulmonary complications, or even possibly the development of second cancers. I think it's very difficult because, number one, nobody expects that cancer even exists in children. And certainly parents are horrified to hear the news. And we recognize that everything we tell them and try and explain about the disease and about its treatment is forgotten within 10 seconds of our having provided the information, just because of the state of shock that you could imagine they're in. So looking at available websites or print material is really very important for families. I think Cancer.Net provides really an exhaustive and complete description of most and even the very rare or less commonly occurring pediatric cancers. As far as basic information about the diagnosis, treatment, new treatment approaches, as well as providing a comprehensive resource of other foundations, organizations where patients and families can find help and support.